Hello and welcome to this quick pitch video on Robustel's R1520G Global 4G router. So we put here the world's most certified 4G router, and why that matters, and for that matter, to whom it matters. So the claim of the world's most certified is we cannot 100% corroborate that, but we don't know of anything that has more regional certifications than this multi-purpose product. So I think we can make the claim until we find out otherwise. But that's what today's quick pitch is about. And so a quick overview of the hardware layer, just simply the tin itself. We've got an analog input, which is, can be used for battery monitoring. We've got digital input, digital outputs for controlling other types of things. It's got 5 Ethernet ports. So if you put this in a panel, it can save you having to buy a separate Ethernet switch. It's got 232 and 485 serial ports. The RS485 is commonly used as a Modbus RTU interface, and there's lots of higher layer software to deal with that. It's got, unfortunately, I'm obscuring the Wi-Fi information, but it's got an access point and a client, Wi-Fi client capability built in. It's got GPS and eMark for in-vehicle applications, and it runs a Category 4 global LTE modem. So, in this quick pitch, let's frame the problem that we're solving with this product. There are two things when you want to deploy products around the world. LTE fragmentation, or 4G frequencies, they are quite different around the world. And this means you might need, on standard products, you would need to have different routers for each region. With the use of the right cellular module, Robustel solved this problem that you can send one router anywhere. And that's not a new thing. That's been around for a little while, but it's now can be done at the right price as well. That is what is new. The bit that is far more pertinent to today's conversation is the certifications. This is where it gets much more difficult. It's often misunderstood and sometimes misrepresented as well. To say you have a global router just by having a global cellular module inside that can connect to networks around the world is arguably a little disingenuous, because the hard bit and the often legally required bit is to have the certifications such as FCC, CE, Telecom J in Japan, RCM for Australia, these sort of regulatory certification. That's a legal issue, so that's not something you can mess about with. You then have GCF and PTCRB, which are telecom industry certs, and then you've got the issue of, well, on some networks you can't operate without their specific certification. So this is a massively time-consuming and bureaucratic process that can add up to a lot of money very quickly. And talking of a lot of money, here's the $100,000 label. You can see many of these standards require that you put a small logo on the router. Not all of them, but we had to put an entirely dedicated new sticker on the R1520 Global to accommodate the ones that are necessary. And here is a map of where the product is specifically certified. Now, something I noticed is I used a slightly out of date map, but I thought it was a really nice thing to show that how all of that orange, because this is a work in progress, all of that orange has now turned green. So NOM in Mexico, Anatel for Brazil, Enacom, I think, for Argentina, and Indonesian certs, they're all in place now for the R1520G. So by GDP, this really is a global product. And it's important to point out other territories that you don't see on the map. It can just be a paperwork exercise to get them covered, to get the formal documentation using the actual tests from FCC or CE to qualify. So hopefully this will give you a feeling for the amount of time and money to achieve this. I think one of the key commercial points is that Robustel has done this so you don't have to. People making their own products, where they're considering shipping outside of Europe and North America maybe, or even outside of Europe, this process is going to get very complicated very quickly. So you might be better off using the R1520 Global, take it outside of your main product, and you leverage the certifications from a telecoms perspective on the router and leave your equipment just to be covered by the most basic regulatory certs. One of the key things that is very positive about this product with FCC, PTCRB, AT&T and Verizon in the States is that you have something that works in the States and works in Europe. So you can cover a large part of product markets where it's, you know, mainly those territories, which are large areas of the world. That's easily done. And in the past, it has proved to be a problem at times to do to go stateside and do the UK and Europe. Just to check the theoretical side of things, we sent a router with a roaming sim around the world, asked someone in a local office to switch it on, and we saw it build a data connection, connect on the cloud platform, and everything was good and as expected. And whilst obviously this, we expect this to be the case, this is another little bit of work that Robustel have done, so you don't have to. We've qualified that the global frequencies and other basic connection parameters are working as expected. A brief aside here about this product is that you can embed your application on the R1520, the R1520 Global, to be precise. So potentially, you can end up with a router and a lower power embedded computer, all with these all covered by these certifications. And so if you just want to send a bit of Modbus data, maybe from the edge to the cloud, you can easily write some code or use Robustel's code to do the same job. Now, typically, when you roll out globally, you need a roaming or multi-network SIM that can go to multiple operators in multiple countries. There are issues with that, generally around automatic network selection. And the smart roaming white paper that you see on the right there, if this describes what you're about to embark on or you're struggling with, then you need to read the white paper and you need to consider smart roaming because it handles some endemic problems in the way that network selection is done. So this is another important part of a global router narrative. Robustel's cloud platform, another important, critical consideration. As soon as your estate size gets up into the tens and twenties of units, if you're obligated to provide a service, you need a way to manage them. And Robustel's basic version is completely free of charge. So it's a complete no-brainer. And as part of the cloud platform, on a pay-as-you-go basis, you can use the integrated VPN capability. So no matter where your device goes in the world, and no matter what you put on the LAN side of it, in this example, we've just used a well-known single board computer, you can make remote connections over any type of internet bearer to both the router and to connected devices. And so if you've had to choose, for example, local SIMs for commercial reasons, then you've still got fixed IP access to those devices. So, world's most certified 4G router makes life easy or easier for companies shipping multinationally, and the router management platform is critical to make sure that you can stay on top of any foibles as they come up. So if you'd like more information, please speak to your local Robustel representative, or you can contact sales@robustel.com for more information. Thanks very much. Bye for now.